Good morning, student. In the last lecture, we have studied about the phylum Porifera to Echinoderma. Today, we are going to study about the phylum Chordata. Let us see first what is the difference between Chordata and non-Chordata. You know, Chordata and non-Chordata means see. Non-Chordata means the organism without backbone. जो ऑर्गेनिज्म को बैकबोन्स नहीं होते द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच हैव नो बैकबोन्स नो व्हाटएवर कॉलम दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म इज कॉल्ड एज द नॉन कॉर्डेटा एंड कॉर्डेटा मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच हैव बैकबोन्स विच हैव व्हाटएवर कॉलम्स दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म इज कॉल्ड एज द कॉर्डेटा इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव सीन द फाइलम पोरिफेरा टू फाइलम इकेनोडर्मेटा These nine phylums, all animals which are present in the phylum Porifera to Echinodermata, all are non-chordates. All are non-chordates. Means why? What? The organism which without backbone, without vertebral column. समझ में आया आपको? Porifera to Echinodermata जो phylum से बेटा, सारे organisms are present in that phylum. They have no backbone. They have no vertebral column. Backbone is also called as vertebral column. But it in the phylum Chordata means the organisms which are present in the phylum Chordata they have a backbone. They have a vertebral column. Got it? समझ में आ गए सबको? Everybody you understand?
Yes.
Let us see the classes. Means see. In the last lecture I explained about that. How does we classify the organisms? मैंने क्लास का एग्जाम्पल दिया था ठीक है मीन्स इन किंगडम एनिमेलिया किंगडम एनिमेलिया वी हैव सीन हाउ मेनी फाइलम्स टेन फाइलम्स मीन्स किंगडम एनिमेलिया हैव अ टेन फाइलम्स वी हैव स्टडी द फाइलम पोरिफेरा टू इकेनोडर्मेटा ऑल ऑर्गेनिजम्स द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विदाउट बैकबोन These all organisms include in the phylum Porifera to Echinodermata. Okay, in the last phylum means kingdom Animalia 10 phylum. Then the phylum Chordata have a 5 classes. This is a classification. This is called as classification. इसके आगे आपको मैंने last lecture I told you about that. Then class, then species, genus. Okay, it is grouping like that as per the characteristics features. Got it? But in we have to study about that only class. हमें बस phylum Chordata के class तक study करने हैं हमें genus species देखना है क्या? No, we have to study only up to the class. Chordata समझ में आ गया आपको? What is mean by Chordata? The organism with backbone. The organism which have vertebral column. These organisms are included in the phylum Chordata. Let us means some animals also, some aquatic animals also chordates. So we have distributed means we have divided the organisms as per the classes. First the class phyces. Let us see one by one each and every class. In the class phyces, all the fish, all the aquatic fish, include in the class. Let us see the characteristics. First, the organisms living in the organism living in the water means all the fish in the class phyces. जितने भी सारे fish हैं बेटा, सब कौन से class में आते हैं?
Class
phyces. Got it? They, you know heart. What is the function of heart? To circulate the blood in our body. All organisms have a heart. This is the Chordata. All the organisms which are included in the classes, they have a heart. We have a human beings. We have a four chamber hearts. Means हमारे heart को four chambers से बेटा. Same the class phyces fish also have a heart. The fish have a two chamber heart. कितने chambers से fish के hearts को?
Two
chambers. The fish respiration through by gills. You know structure. What is the diagram of fish? In the like that, ऐसी जो diagrams होती बेटा, they have a like that. This is called as gills. We respiration through our nose. The fish respiration through the gills. Got it? can locomotion. Fish can swimming in the water. Got it? The fish is the cold-blooded. You know cold-blooded, warm-blooded?
Yes.
What is mean by cold-blooded? Means see, we are warm-blooded. Means we keep our constant temperature in any environment, yeah. In any season. Means winter season, summer season, rainy season, our temperature is 37 degree centigrade. Means we have a constant temperature. Jinka constant temperature hota hai beta, this organism is called as the warm-blooded. This organism is called as the warm-blooded. And jo organism, they cannot keep the constant body temperature. In winter season, their body temperature is down, decrease. In the summer season, their body temperature is increased. These organisms is called as the cold-blooded. Kya kehte unko? Cold-blooded. Understood? Warm-blooded, cold-blooded. In spices ke baare mein humne kya sikha? What is the characteristics?
Two-chamber
heart. Respiration through by gills. They locomotion through by fins. They are cold-blooded animals. They living in the water. Got it everybody? Means you have to study at least these 4-5 points you will learn. And their body have a scales like structure. Scales hote na?
Yes.
Fish, dekha hai apne fish? Scales hote. Means jisko hum khole khole kehte uske upar body ke. Means it is a hard structure sir, present over the skin. This is called the scales. Got it everybody? Spices samajh mein aa gaya sabko? Everybody understood spices? Next, we see spices means all organisms are living in the aquatic. All organisms are aquatic means they are living in the water. Fishes in the including the spices. Amphibia. Amphibia means the organism living in the water as well as land. This organism is called as the amphibia. You know frog.
Yes. Crocodile.
Crocodile. Frog, crocodile. Living in the water also as well as living
yes.
in the soil also.
Yes.
Got it? This is called as a terrestrial. Then the organisms of amphibian, their skin is a gland. These glands secrete the substance. So their skin is a moist.
Yes. Yes.
Got it? You have seen the frog, their skin is very shiny, moist. Because why? Some glands are present over the skin and these glands secrete the secretion. So due to this secretion, the organisms keep their skin is a moist. Amphibian is the aquatic as well as terrestrial. They are respiration through by skin and lungs.
Yes.
Our respiratory organ is the lungs.
Yeah.
We are respiration through by lungs. Respiration lesson mein humne dekha hai. We have studied about the plant. But the amphibian, the spices, respiration through by gills.
Yes.
Listen to me carefully. Amphibian, respiration through by lungs or skin. They are a three-chamber heart. Unke kitne chambers hote heart ko? Three-chamber hearts. Got it? And they are also, means the eyelids are movable. You
yes.
see?
Yes.
Have you seen the frog?
Yes.
Their eyelids are movable. Got it, buddy?
Yes.
What I told about the amphibian?
They
are a three-chamber heart. The respiration through by skin and lungs. The organisms living in the water as well as in the soil. Their skin present the gland. They secrete some secretion. Due to this secretion, they keep their skin is moist. What is?
Yes.
Their eyelids are moveable.
Yes.
Understood? Crocodile, frog. They are amphibian. समझ में आ गए बेटा? देखो spices living in the water, amphibian they are living in the water as well as in the soil, terrestrial. समझ में आ गए everybody? You got it?
Yes.
Then next is the class reptilia. The class reptilia means the organisms have a rough skin. Have you seen lizard,
yes.
snake, tortoise? Their skin have a dry, rough skin. Got it? They respiration through by lungs. Reptiles also respiration through by lungs. They are respiration through by means you distinguish the characteristics, same characteristics, but which are in the spices, amphibian. In the reptiles, they are respiration through by means the respiratory organs kya hai? Lungs. इसमें गिल से इन द एम्फीबिया स्किन एज वेल एज लम्स रेप्टाइल्स लम्स एंड दे हैव अ इनकम्प्लीट फोर चेम्बर हार्ट. जो रेप्टाइल्स होते हैं उनका हार्ट कितनी चेम्बर से है? फोर है बट इनकम्प्लीट है. गॉट इट? स्पाइसेस इज द टू चेम्बर हार्ट. एम्फीबियन हैव अ फोर चेम्बर हार्ट, सॉरी थ्री चेम्बर हार्ट. रेप्टाइल्स इज अ फोर चेम्बर बट फोर चेम्बर इज अ इनकम्प्लीट. दे आर ऑल्सो कोल्ड ब्लडेड. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पोकिलोथर्मल. पोकिलोथर्मल मीन्स कोल्ड ब्लडेड. यू नो कोल्ड ब्लडेड. द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर हाइबरनेट. हाइबरनेट मीन्स विंटर स्लीप समर स्लीप. दे कैनॉट एडजस्ट द बॉडी टेम्परेचर इन पर्टिकुलर सीजन बिकॉज दे आर अ कोल्ड ब्लडेड. सो दे आर अ हाइबरनेट. दे आर अ विंटर स्लीप समर स्लीप. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द विंटर स्लीप इज कॉल्ड एज द हाइबरनेशन. वेदांत अंडरस्टूड बेटा व्हाट इज मीन बाय हाइबरनेशन. मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम द रेप्टाइल्स दे आर स्लीपिंग इन विंटर. दिस इज कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड एज द हाइबरनेशन. अंडरस्टूड? दे आर अ ओवी पोरस. देखो ओवी पोरस एंड बीवी पोरस. ओवी पोरस मीन्स एग्स लेइंग एनिमल. जो एनिमल्स एग्स ले करते हैं दिस एनिमल इज कॉल्ड एज द ओवी पोरस. ओवी पोरस. ओवी पोरस मीन्स वॉट? एग्स लेइंग एनिमल्स. एंड बीवी पोरस मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर गिव द बर्थ देयर बेबीज. जो बेबी को बॉर्न करते हैं दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म इज कॉल्ड एज द बीवी पोरस. एंड ओवी पोरस मीन्स एग्स लेइंग एनिमल. रेप्टाइल्स समझ में आ गए आपको? रेप्टाइल्स क्लास. द ऑर्गेनिजम्स इज अ ड्राई स्किन रफ स्किन. दे हैव अ फोर इनकम्प्लीट चेम्बर्स ऑफ द हार्ट. दे रेस्पिरेशन थ्रू बाय लंग्स. दे आर अ कोल्ड ब्लडेड. दे आर अ हाइबरनेटिंग सिमस. इन दिस विंटर स्लीपिंग इज कॉल्ड एज द हाइबरनेशन. देन द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर अ ओविपोरस. इज दे आर अ एग लेइंग एनिमल. एंड द फर्टिलाइजेशन इज एक्सटर्नली. मीन्स यू नो द सम बर्ड सम ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर ले द एग्स. दे हैचिंग द एग्स. देन द स्मॉल यंग वंस आर कम आउट फ्रॉम द एग्स. दिस प्रोसेस इज एक्सटर्नली. वॉट इट मीन्स? द जो भी यंग वंस होता है बेटा उसकी फॉर्मेशन कैसे होता है? दिस फॉर्मेशन इन द एग्स इज एक्सटर्नली. वॉट इट? इन द विविपोरस द स्मॉल यंग वन डेवलप देयर ऑर्गन्स इन द मदर्स यूटेरस. अंडरस्टूड? आपको रेप्टाइल समझ में आ गया? देन नेक्स्ट इज द क्लास एव्स. ऑल द बर्ड्स सारे जो बर्ड्स है दे आर इंक्लूड इन द क्लास एव्स. देखो स्पाइसेस मीन्स ऑल द फिश. ऑल द फिशेस ऑल द ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक अ फिश इंक्लूड इन द क्लास स्पाइसेस. एम्फीबियन द ऑर्गेनिजम्स लिविंग इन द aquatic water and their soil they are in the amphibian. Their respiration through by lungs and skin. Reptiles means all the animals they are living in the water also and soil also but they have a hibernate cold blooded. What it? Amphibian is also cold blooded. Both are cold blooded. Got it? Then eggs means all the birds. All the birds are included in the class Aves. They are arboreal animal. Arboreal animals. Arboreal animals means the animals living on the tree. You know the birds are making the nest on the tree. They are laying the eggs in the nest. Tree means the tree is their house. कहाँ पे रहते हैं? वो tree पे रहते हैं. This tree is their house. This animal is called as the arboreal animal. Got it? समझ में आ गए बेटा? एव्स मीन्स ऑल द बर्ड्स दे आर इंक्लूड इन द क्लास एव्स. दे ऑल्सो हैव अ फोर चेम्बर हार्ट. उनका भी हार्ट के कितने चेम्बर्स होते हैं? फोर चेम्बर्स. दे ऑल्सो देयर बॉडी इज लाइक दैट मीन्स बोथ साइड लाइक सी लाइक दैट बॉडी यू नो पॉइंटेड बिकॉज दे कैन फ्लाइट with the help of this body. Their body covered by the colorful feathers. Feathers होते हैं birds की body में. समझ में आ गया? Anybody have any doubt? They have a pair of limbs. You know limbs means four limbs, hind limbs, This is the forelimbs. Legs is called as the hind limbs. In the birds, forelimbs is developed into the wings. Forelimbs unke wings mein develop hote hai. So we call the birds have only two legs.
Yes.
The birds have a forelimbs. Pair of limbs. Two pair of limbs. The forelimbs means hand, which is developed into the wings. And the hind limb is the legs. Got it? Birds ke baare mein samajh mein aa gaya. The birds is also oviparous. They also laying a egg. The birds are warm blooded. Birds are warm blooded. Got it?
Yes.
क्या क्या characteristics बताया मैंने एव्स के बारे में? The एव्स means all the birds are included in the एव्स class. They are arboreal. Means arboreal means they are living on the tree. Another, they respirate through by lungs. The birds have a four chamber hearts. They are a pair of limbs, two pair of limbs, four limbs, hind limbs. Four limbs is modified into the wings. The body covered by the colorful feather. Understood? Anybody have any doubt? सबको समझ में आ गया बेटा class aves in the class and these aves is also oviparous means all the birds also laying the eggs and baby is hatches from the eggs. But it means they also fertilization is externally. इंटरनल नहीं होते बॉडी के अंदर फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं होता फर्टिलाइजेशन कहाँ होता है एक्सटर्नल एग्स में होता है ना गॉट इट देन क्लास मैमेलिया मीन्स ह्यूमन बींग्स ऑल एनिमल्स दे आर अ विविपोरस द ऑर्गेनिज्म दे कैन गिव द बर्थ देयर बेबीज दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म इज कॉल्ड एज द विविपोरस विविपोरस देयर बॉडी प्रेजेंट अ हेयर The body covered the hair. The body, they also have a four chamber heart. The mammals, जो mammals क्यों कहा जाता है बेटा? They can born their babies. Got it?
Yes.
Their body covered the hair. They have their respiration through by lungs. Their heart is also have a
four chambers.
Got it? They are a fertilization internally. इंटरनली फर्टिलाइजेशन करते हैं ना वो मीन्स सी विविपोरस मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे कैन विच गिव द बर्थ देयर बेबी मीन्स द यंग वन डेवलप देयर ऑर्गन इनसाइड द मदर गॉट इट जो भी होते हैं बेटा डॉग कैट टाइग्रेस जो भी एनिमल्स है दे आर गिव द बर्थ दे आर गिविंग द बर्थ देयर बेबीज The babies develop their organs internally in the mother's uterus. Understood? Anybody have any doubt about the five classes? Everybody, you understood the lesson?
Yes.
In that lesson, we have studied about the five kingdom classification. First, we have seen the five kingdom: kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, and kingdom Animalia. In the kingdom Animalia, we have seen the 10 phylum. Phylum Porifera to phylum Echinodermata are non-chordates and in the last 10th phylum is the phylum Chordata. The phylum Chordata is subdivided into the class. Spices, amphibia, reptiles, caves and mammals. Everybody, you understood the topic?
Yes.